A despicable man who has terrorized the people of Wano. A man who has committed acts so treacherous and heinous that he seems more of a parasite than a human. And like a true pest, he may be tricky to kill. So how will it be done? Hello my Nakamatachi, this is JoyGirl with a video discussing how I picture Orochi's death. And before we begin, I do need to explain that this discussion is not a theory. It is simply as the title suggests. A discussion of essentially what I would like to see happen. This is a new series that I'm embarking on because my brain is practically filled up with only One Piece, and if you were to dissect it at any given point, you'd probably just witness some crazy scenario unfold. The focus of today's discussion is that of Orochi's death. Orochi is truly a character who deserves his comeuppance, and over the course of the Wano arc, I have had many ideas as to how this could happen. Whilst I'm sure Oda will go beyond our expectations and what we will get of Orochi's end will be even better than what I had imagined, in the meantime, it's still fun to picture what that would be. And on that note, I invite all of you to detail your idea about how Orochi will meet his deserved demise by leaving a comment below. Who knows, maybe it will be your idea which we will actually see play out in the series. I'm sure many of you have also devised some pretty thrilling scenarios in your heads, so this is your opportunity to share your thoughts, and hey, perhaps we can all celebrate together if one of us actually gets it right. In saying that, please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already so that you don't miss out on that big hurrah if any of you do actually get it right, but even aside from this, so that you don't miss out on any future One Piece discussions. I should also warn anime-only fans that this video will contain some discussion of content which has not yet been animated, so please feel free to watch another video and return to this one at a later date when you are all caught up. For everyone else, the first thing I need to address is that this discussion is a video that I had actually planned on releasing a while ago, but then I had to scrap because, well, Orochi died? Not really, but at least it was suggested that Kaido had killed him. Although, as you will know if you've been following this channel for a while, I didn't believe that for a second, so I did still have an idea as to how we would really see his death, but week by week, chapter by chapter, we received new developments in the story which meant my thoughts weren't really plausible. So in saying that, how I picture Orochi's death now has changed from how I initially saw his death playing out. But how I originally pictured Orochi's death was that the Shogun would be in his Zoan form, fighting against most, but not all of the scabbards. I believe that not all of the scabbards would be fighting Orochi, because for example, Kinemon's battle would be rather against Kanjuro because of their history together, what with the two having spent the most time together after leaving Raizo at Zou when they arrived 20 years into the future, and due to the fact that as they both traveled in time, this means that they may be closer in strength as they didn't have the 20 years to train and further hone their combat skills. As well as the idea that Kinemon, as the leader of the scabbards, may feel that it is his responsibility to deal with the traitor. This would then leave Denjiro, Kiku, Raizo, Inu, Neko, Kawamatsu, Ashura, and Izo, who had also arrived at Wano by this point, making up 8 individuals able to each slice off one of Orochi's heads. However, that still wasn't quite how I pictured it, because I also thought Raizo, Inu, and Neko would be preoccupied with matchups of their own due to their own personal histories against other individuals, namely Fukurokuju and Jack the Drought. And then there were 5, which actually fit the scenario I had in mind. If Kaido had decapitated Orochi's head as a human, it was possible that he had lost one of his 8 heads in his Zoan form, meaning he only had 7 left. I pictured that the remaining scabbards, Denjiro, Kiku, Kawamatsu, Ashura, and Izo, would be battling the now 7-headed snake, with particularly Denjiro and Kawamatsu leading the charge. The reason for this is because both Denjiro and Kawamatsu were the closest to Hiyori as her protectors after Odin's execution. Following the tragedy, Kawamatsu and Denjiro took turns in being the principal carers for the young girl, ensuring she survives and keeping her identity hidden. Considering then how Hiyori, as Komurasaki, had to entertain the despised Orochi for all those years, I think Denjiro and Kawamatsu, fueled by their anger, were the perfect individuals to lead the fight against Orochi, ultimately with each of the 5 scabbards being able to take off Orochi's heads. However, this still meant that two heads were left. And this is where I saw Momonosuke and Hiyori step in. These two siblings would join in the fight once Orochi was worn out from fighting the scabbards. And with only two snake heads left, the Kozuki heirs would finish him off, marking the end of Orochi's wicked rule and the rise of a new era with Wano being led by its true leader. But like I said, a lot of what I've said up to this point is now rendered unlikely because of where the story has gone, though it does seem like we are seeing some of this come to life, such as the fight against Raizo and Fukurokuju, and we have already witnessed the Mink Dukes taking on Jack, soon for a round 2 with just Inu against the Calamity. On the other hand, there are also lots of other developments which contradict the scenario I had in mind, such as Ashura's fate being questionable after the bomb blast in chapter 1008, or the fact that Orochi's fate too is now again unknown after chapter 1009, where he has already faced the scabbards and lost many of his heads, meaning that I have since revised how Orochi's death will play out. And so, this is how I now picture Orochi's death. Based on what happened in the latest chapter, it seems like Orochi will only have one head left. And I do want to thank all of you who pointed out in the comments section that there were indeed 6 and not only 5 heads cut off in the last chapter like I said in the chapter review. So then that means with the head that Kaido chopped off and now with the additional 6, making 7 lost in total, Orochi should be down to his last head. And if it is the case that Orochi has to have all of his heads cut off to die, then I think that it is only right that Hiyori has the honor and the glory of killing Orochi for good. Having been the Kozuki child who stayed behind rather than go forth in time, Hiyori endured 20 years of hell, witnessing all the atrocities that Orochi committed. To make matters worse, Hiyori had to serve Orochi whilst working as an Oiran despite her hatred for the man. So to have Hiyori kill Orochi would be just poetic justice. And this could be even more effective and emotionally weighted if we take into the account the theory that Orochi is Tama's father, which some of you have kindly introduced me to in the comment section, and when I looked into this theory a little deeper, which seemed to have started as far back as 2018 from what I could find, some people believe that Tama would be the child of Orochi and Hiyori, which personally, I don't quite like the idea of. I think this would be just a bit too dark for One Piece, though the series has admittedly had plenty of its darker moments. And I think I just dislike Orochi so much that I can't stand the thought of Hiyori having to have suffered to that extent, mothering a child to a man who killed her own father. As well as for Tama and the shock and horror that the sweet, poor, innocent girl must feel if she finds out the truth of her father. In saying that, I do think it's possible that Tama could certainly be a Kurozumi, but I would think that Tama and Orochi are relatives, not direct father and child. Nevertheless, even without all of this, another reason which I think makes sense for Hiyori to kill Orochi is that we witnessed Hiyori say in her own words that she would like to kill him herself. As to how this would happen, well, seeing as the scabbards have already run through Orochi and quickly disposed of him, focused on more pressing matters in the form of Kaido, I think it will be someone else who helps Hiyori. And that is her brother Momonosuke. That's right, I am in part holding on to my original scenario that it will be ultimately the siblings who bring about Orochi's demise. The reason for this is that though Orochi has been dealt a fair amount of damage so far, I do find it hard to believe that Hiyori would be able to defeat him all by herself, especially when we take into account his devil fruit powers, of which we haven't really seen its fighting capabilities, and simultaneously, a lack of knowledge of her fighting skills. I do think it's a bit far-fetched that Hiyori would beat him by herself, and I think Momo helping her will fit quite nicely, though not going to the extent of killing Orochi himself, as Momo's story has always been tied to Kaido. It's not very clear from the latest chapter as to whereabouts inside the castle the scabbards met Orochi, though we can assume that it was still near the treasure repository and perhaps still on the second floor. In my video discussing Momo's role in the arc, I discussed how the right brain tower and the treasure repository I likely placed on the same floor given the details we got in the manga, and the last known location of Momo's group was the right brain tower, meaning that even if they have left that tower itself since then, they are likely still on the same floor and close to where the showdown between Orochi and the scabbards took place. And though, as you know, I have been enthusiastically on the Toki train for the identity of the mystery figure from chapter 1004, Hiyori has always been my alternate answer, whom I did say was perhaps the more logical or straightforward answer, though my heart wishes that it is Toki. But if it is indeed Hiyori and Momo has met his sister, then this is how I imagine the scene to play out. Momo's group will run into Orochi, who is manic at facing the heir of the Kozuki family. The two will engage in a fierce battle. Perhaps by using this fight to avenge his parents, Momo could learn to control his devil fruit powers at this moment, using them against Orochi, or failing that, rely on Yamato and Shinobu for help, resulting in Orochi being almost completely defeated. However, before he takes the finishing blow, Momo takes a step back and simply says, "You are not mine to kill." Enter Hiyori. The last thing Orochi experiences is the dawning realization that the Oiran with whom he had been infatuated is none other than the daughter of Kozuki Oden. A twisted irony that ties up many loose ends in a very satisfying end. It would provide a nice twist to the folklore on which Orochi seems to have been inspired from, where in the tale the Yamato no Orochi was defeated by Susanoo, the storm god of the Shinto religion, who killed the eight-headed serpent to save a woman who was going to be offered as a sacrifice to the fearsome beast. In One Piece, instead of being a damsel in distress needing saving, Hiyori would be taking matters into her own hands, killing the creature who caused the death of her parents and led Wano to ruin. This would also resolve a problem that many have had with the Wano arc, that being the treatment of Hiyori's character. Since the reveal of Komurasaki as Hiyori, many fans have been disappointed about Hiyori is no longer the cunning, steel-hearted woman using her wits and beauty to manipulate others, and rather reduced to being another typical, helpless princess in need of saving. A source of disgruntlement which would likely subside if we witnessed her getting a piece of the action herself and actually kill Orochi for good, thereby redeeming Hiyori's character, although I can't say that I particularly find this all that needed. This would also allow Momo to go on to have his own moment against Kaido himself, which is the route that I think Oda is taking and one that I already discussed in another video. As for this one, I still do find myself questioning whether Orochi will be so weak already and be reduced to having only one snake head left. Whilst it is practically confirmed that Orochi is based off the Yamato no Orochi of Japanese mythology, as that is the name of his devil fruit, the Hebi Hebi no Mi, model Yamato no Orochi, it could be argued that he also does bear some similarity to the Linnaean Hydra, a serpent-like beast of Greek and Roman mythology who also has many heads, though its exact number or the limit of how many heads it can grow is unclear. And going further, for every head that the Hydra loses, it grows another two in its place. If Oda draws some inspiration from this mythological creature as well, then we may find Orochi with not just one head, but in fact, almost double what he originally had. Or even if Orochi can't regenerate two heads to replace the one he loses, it doesn't necessarily mean that he can't regenerate any of the heads he has previously lost. In the latest chapter, it's possible that Oda deliberately drew Orochi's Zoan form in such a small panel and in a way that it wouldn't be clear how many heads he had left after his decapitation at the hands of Kaido. It's possible that even after the scabbard's attack, he can still regrow his heads. I mean, I just can't imagine that Orochi will be so easy to defeat. In saying that, even if it is the case that Orochi still has many heads left, I think some of the Alliance members will be able to help Hiyori defeat him. If anything, Orochi being defeated at the hands of the Wano citizens will be a great scene to witness. with all those who mourn Odin's death and despise Orochi for what he did, with memories of people like Yusui still burning fresh in their minds, I can imagine the wrath of Wano being unleashed on Orochi, culminating in the final blow dealt by a character who perhaps perfectly encapsulates all of their pain and anguish, Hiyori. Although, there is something which we do have to mention. This is One Piece, and we may not actually witness Orochi die at all. Villains do not die in One Piece, as punishment is portrayed to be a worse fate than death. Rather than killing off his villains, Oda portrays the ultimate defeat to be one not being able to live out and fulfill their dreams and ideals, so it is more than possible that this is how Orochi will be dealt with too. However, with that being said, Orochi is perhaps the most despicable character I have come across so far in One Piece that I just want him gone. So for now, even if it's just for my sheer twisted pleasure, I'm sticking with what I had imagined, that Hiyori will be the one to kill Orochi with her own hands. And with that image, we come to the end of today's discussion. Don't forget to leave a comment below about your own idea on this topic. This is JoyGirl, and I'll see you again soon.